This is Enterprise Automation for SAP S/4HANA. My name is John Liu, and today we'll find out how you can automate your financial processes to improve your business operations. Today, I am joined by SAP Build Process Automation Product Manager, Evgeny Gorbunov. Welcome. So lead to cash is a crucial role in every company's business operations, and it's important for all processes to work together and create the best experiences both internally and for our customers. So let's look at a specific example. Evgeny, when we were working with billing documents creation and posting, what are the challenges and how does this affect operations?
First of all, thanks for the invite, John. Happy to be here. And of course, let's discuss it. The common issues could be that billing documents can be not invoiced until the end of the billing period, released with a delay, or even reverted. It is, of course, important for us to have the visibility of these KPIs and track the blockers we might need to address. Otherwise, it would affect our sales operations in general. We can have delays with document processing, or this can lead to additional manual efforts.
That certainly sounds like a challenge. So from your experience working with customers, does this occur often?
I would say very common, and it depends on how we process the document creation, document posting, which checks do we implement, and how do we define the extension and approval processes around this. So say we run into certain limits, a credit limit, and with that we want to react somehow. And in order to identify these inefficiencies, we can leverage SAP Signavio and get specific recommendations on top of that on how it can be handled.
Right. So discovering the inefficiencies, it seems like it's quite useful, especially for businesses with so many complex processes. So how would one respond to the blocked sales orders?
So let's say we have sales orders that are blocked because they exceed the credit limit in SAP S/4HANA. We would like to unblock them by applying a certain approval flow that can also start automatically. With this, we can easily review the related sales orders and their overdue duration and remove the blocks where it is applicable. And that is something we can actually address with the help of SAP Build Process Automation.
Right. That makes sense. So in this case, what role does SAP Build Process Automation then play?
Well, first, we can leverage the pre-built content to manage credit blocks on sales orders in SAP S/4HANA, which can also be adapted to our specific needs. And I will show you the glimpse of it in a minute. After that, by leveraging action triggering capability, the approval process to increase the credit limit can be automatically started without any human action. This way, we can make the process centralized and well-maintained.
Right, that sounds like a great outcome. And yes, please show us what this looks like in the system.
We start with SAP Signavio Process Insights, where we can see the most frequent blockers and other related information to our process flows. So we're looking into the lead to cash area, and then we're looking into the sales billing document creation process. And then we can also get a set of recommendations on what and where we can improve. And so then it tells us also to look at the credit block management on the sales orders. So those are all pre-built content packages that we can apply with Build Process Automation. We want to dive deeper and we go to SAP Signavio Process Intelligence, where we can do the proper order to cache investigation and see how a process is performing, where we have the major delays. And then it allows us to really get to the core of the problem, to really understand it, and then make a process-driven decision on which scenario do we need to implement or which pre-built content package do we need to apply. In this case, we proceed with managed credit block on sales order, and with this, we go to SAP Build Store, and we acquire this package in order to adjust it to our specific needs. And then we deploy it to our tenant. We can also adjust it. And here we have the decision to define who is the right approver. In case we need to unblock the credit limit on the sales order, then we send this person the approval form, and then we are unblocking this in the system. And this is how the form looks like. Of course, we can customize it, we can still adjust it, right? And then we can let the person, the manager, review all the information and decide if we want to approve or reject this unblock procedure. And after this, if we unblock it, we can see that our sales order is in the system and the status is that it's not blocked.
Great. So to summarize, we've reviewed how you can use automation to unblock credit limit sales orders across your financial processes. You know, thank you very much, Evgeny, for sharing. And if you're interested to learn more about enterprise automation, then head on over to sap.com/enterprise-automation. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.